on with the dream fish. Like it, Toma! This is Merwin's biggest carp, probably. What's your grootste voor die, Toma? Net as in 88 centimeters. This is definitely better.
Yeah.
This was on a squid bait. The live bait washed out of the spot. The thinner braid is sitting better. Yeah, it's a lovely feeling. This is a nice fish.
Okay. Gaan, gaan, gaan.
Come on, come on. Wacht, 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 wacht.
Gaan, 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 gaan. Kom, kom.
Ja, yes, he's gonna be so stoked. Oh, so mooi vis. Just keep him in order.
Yes.
Nice. Well done. Stunning. 122 centimeters. Okay, now terug in die water. Terug. So. Okay. Hoe voel hy al beter?
Hy doen gereed
op begin. Hy sal jullie uit die handen uit kan skop. Los hom vang. Los hom vang. Dat ek kyk of hy recht op blijf. As hy nie wat, hy is recht. Bye papa.
Morning. Good morning. So. We're back at the sea. We're looking for a cob. I'm gonna fish some lures. I want to show you guys what I did last night. So I couldn't find any of the nice bull minnows anymore. Couldn't find any, had like a whitish color, which I don't like on this coast. I like a red, dark red, purplish. So I dug into my girlfriend's nail polish, Q-tex, I don't know what you call the stuff, and a little did a little bit of painting. Not that nice as I would have liked it, but you know what? I think it's gonna do the job. Looks nice here, it's a little bit of a far throw, but yeah. Ooh. Water is nice. Water's a bit up, a little bit big, but I'm sure we can sort something out. Okay, so the idea here is to reach that bank at the back there. It's a little bit far, but the lure throws nicely, so ooh, in the money zone. I'm trying a slow jig. And I was just talking to my friend Richard. I haven't even moved the jig yet, and we're on a little bubba. But you know, nice, something different. Okay, teeny tiny little cob. There's a jig I'm trying, and it's definitely working. Okay, I'm gonna put this little oaky back. Actually, very nice eating size. There we go. Got a big buddy. We are making our way down the surf here. It's beautiful. Sea's a bit strong, it's a bit rough. So today, I won't say the hole, you fish a bank that's close to deep water, that's fairly quiet. So in other words, you stay away from the very, very shallow places.
There's a deep trough with a bank at the back.
That's the type of spot you fish. Sea's still a bit high, it's gonna drop a bit still. So, good job. Some ugly weather at the back here.
See the remains, the skull of a whale. Crazy, eh?
There's a few mullets in here.
Not a lot.
Yeah, I'm gonna show you guys how to rig a circle with two little cable ties on the mullet. Just through there. You don't tighten it all the way. Just must still have some play. So this cable tie can go through here. Just like that, leave a little loop. Hook your hook through it. And there we go. Keep your plastics, guys. Don't throw your plastics on the beach.
When we're fishing in the surf zone like this, we have to wade onto the edges and throw to those back banks. I would suggest you guys get a jacket like this. This is our Catch Cook jacket. It's a quiver double yoke. Really cool jacket. Keeps the water out. Got a nice pouch in the front here. I keep all my lures in there. These are really awesome jackets, guys. Go check out the site. Well, Duncan is hopefully catching us lunch here. How's it feel, Duncan? What is it? Is it lunch?
20 pound braid, so it's a nice fight, whatever it is. Always fun.
Well, you're like half a kilometer from the water's edge, so.
it's not doing much. It might be a sandy.
A little bit of a shake.
Might be a small cobby.
Hey, there's a shake, or is that you shaking? That no, could be you.
No, I don't shake.
So there's a sandy, we might use the head as bait. There's a nice lip here for a shark. And we might cook the fillet. They've got brilliant fillet. Really nice eating, apparently. I haven't tried them. Also quite a sustainable thing to eat. You're allowed one per person per day, so you can stay within your limit. And it is a tiny lesser. Don't you've got a bait for the shark.
And Frenna's hooked into something big on the live bait, hoping a big carp.
It's important to take your time, guys. Very important, just to take your time. This is a cob.
I think it's definitely bigger than 9 kilos.
Might be strong in this current, but...
Can you just tell the folks what hook you use for the live bait?
This was that earlier on I showed you guys, a live bait rig. There's a 6-0 Mercury Fusion in there, circle. Two little cable ties in the live bait's nose. Ooh, slowly, aren't very big, so I don't think it's a massive fish.
And this reel is up for the fight.
Oh yes.
Pen.
Oh, conflict.
Yeah, pen conflict. Is that an 8,000 or 6,000?
6,000. See, there's a northerly wind blowing. Normally dries out everything. So I just dip my rod just to keep the tip wet, so it doesn't chafe there, because there's a lot of tension on the tip as it is now.
We're probably about 12 minutes into the fight now. Finally come over that little
lip, yeah, but now there's so much current here. We're bigger than 12 kilos.
Yeah. Wow.
Woo! It's a bus!
It's a bus!
Hey! It's a bus! Yes, man! Yes!
What a beaut!
And so I'm just sitting on her so she can get some energy back. It's important to take good care when releasing them. There we go! Someone kicked out of my hand! That's a beauty fish. That's well in the 20s of 25 odd kilos. She's gone! See, take your time, guys. Take your time. Lekker. It's your biggest one you've seen, eh?
By far. Jeez, what
it's
an experience.
144 centimeters. That's quite a big fish. It's about, I don't know how much that is, but I would rate about a 27, 28 kilo fish. Very, very, very nice condition. But, and she's swimming. So yeah, check, guys. Be vigilant in what you take. Don't kill a fish like that, please, guys. Let's look after our fish for the future. Okay, so we're tight again. Woo! Not even 5 minutes in the water. Let me just check where he is. Really scared he picks me up. Just that side of him, it seems. This one's a bit smaller than the previous one, but also a nice fish. Not a giant. Oh. Okay, there's a nice little grip here, guys. Don't stick your hands inside the gills, just grip in here. Nice little grip. Oh, it's just keeping him in the water, guys. Yeah, look at these beautiful colors, eh? Check at these big fins. Look at this purple on his head. It's a beautiful one. It's stronger than the other one, so I think you should go very quickly. Check. Yeah. There we go. So put a bait out for Duncan. Are you fast, bruh?
Yeah, fast. Finally.
Keep up with him, yeah.
Don't make this too tight, eh? My first live bait.
carp. I have been throwing for them, but I haven't had much luck, so I slid one out.
It's a nice fish. Coming.
It's hard to tell.
Is he heavy?
I haven't. My biggest was on a throw bait of 9.6. It might just be the mullet coming back.
It's not the mullet, trust me. Ooh, there's a bit of shakes. There we go. Keep coming. If he comes, bring him. There we go. Just keep on him like that. Perfect. It's nice to have distance between you and the fish. Then the stretch will stop the fish from coming off you really easily.
I think it's definitely your PB.
Not too hard. Not too hard. Nice. Nice. Smile. You have to push him a little bit.
101.
Well done. Okay, cool. Get the little hook out there. Carefully, it doesn't bite you. And it's gone.
Oh, lekker.
Lekker, man, lekker.
Duncan caught a Sandy, a lesser, and we use a head for shark bait because it swallowed the hook. It was bleeding really badly, so I didn't want to waste the rest of the body. I'm not going to go fishing for sharks anytime soon, so I thought, okay, cool. Right, I'm going to try and cook this thing. A friend of mine said it's really good. It's got some very good meat on it, so yeah, I'm going to try and make some little deep-fried, some gin-battered deep-fried bolikis and use it in a salad. Nice mixing bowl. I'm going to make a batter. 50 grams of flour, tablespoon of bicarb, teaspoon of salt, and girlfriend's pink gin and tonic. Yes. So what the alcohol is gonna do, it's gonna, ooh, look at all the fizziness. It's gonna make the batter nice and light. What's this together? So it's gonna make it nice and light and crispy. You're gonna really see all the little foamy bubbles here. Green stuff, some tomatoes, a little feta, avocado, some of these bad boys, and then a little balsamic vinegar. And there we go. There's a nice little salad. It's actually really nice. I'm impressed. I really am impressed. Sandy's brilliant, man. Got the softest texture. Don't waste, guys. Try and use everything that we harvest nowadays. All life is sacred, so keep a watch for the next video, guys. Click like and subscribe if you like this video. Hit the little bell notification so you can know what we're doing, when the new video is up and everything. So sweet. Thanks for joining me, guys.